Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to heaven.
Paradise.
Eden.
Your dream home.
Luxurious living.
Spacious layout.
Designer decor.
En bloc potential.
Guaranteed returns.
Rate check.
Must view.
Highest offer secured.
Facing north.
South.
East.
But
never west.
Panoramic view of the city.
Of the sea.
Of greenery.
Of the swimming pool.
Of other people's swimming pool.
Other people's living rooms.
Other people's backyards.
And other people's dirty laundry.
Prime location. Near Orchard.
Near amenities.
Near good school.
Near MRT.
Near future MRT.
Near future casino.
Near gambling den.
Pawn shops.
Funeral parlors.
Cemeteries.
Oi! Hello! Cemeteries?
Yeah, what? Peaceful and green.
Pawn shops! Gambling den!
Hey. Exciting nightlife!
Oi, Boon! How long have you been selling property?
Do you even know how to?
Yes, of course!
I tell you what, the trick is imagination. You see, you're not selling a flat. You're not selling a condominium, a semi-D, a good-class bungalow, a mansion on a hill. No. You are selling a lifestyle. That is, a style of life that they do not yet possess, but on the cusp of attaining.
Huh?
What? Cups?
That's right, cusp. Use words like that they don't understand. But the smell of that high-class aircon air belongs to green.
And they vanish. When you show them the window, they can see the super ugly tree. You don't just say, look, a tree. No. You let them imagine being woken up in the morning by the gentle chirping of the...
Ah, Oreos!
Very good. Oreos in the tree. You don't just say, you can put a double bed here. No. You let them see themselves in that king-size bed. What snuggle under the goose feather duvet, gently roused by the sunlight seeping in between the leaves of that super nice tree and the soft warbling of the bird.
Oreos! Good. If the park's a sweaty 15-minute walk away, then please, make use of it. Let them imagine the children happily climbing trees or cycling bicycles around the park.
No, but what if the children are actually stuck
Never
in the-
Never mind! If that poor child is going to be stuck in the pathetic excuse of a study, doing past year papers.
Yeah. You tell them about those good schools within 2 kilometers and their imagination will fill in the gap of obedient little children who win scholarships to study at Warwick University.
Life will be perfect once they move into their dream home.
There will be no more arguments, no more tensions with that panoramic sea view.
No quarrel that cannot be solved by A1 designer decor and a private lift lobby.
No betrayal that cannot be overcome by infinity lab pools.
Jacuzzi pools.
Children's fun pools.
Koi ponds.
Your most powerful tool is their own desires. So use them. Tap them. The more unattainable the vision, the more their hearts will desire it.
It's the details that make them bite.
Why not? You offer them paradise on earth, and all they need to do is...
bring that check!
Actually, not that bad lah, huh? Oh, but not that bad. But you really need to clean up this place a little bit lah. Aiyo. Get a new paint job, and maybe polish the floor. Oh, I know a guy who did it that under 2K, you know. Oh, that's a very good job. And please change those kitchen cabinets also, Mama, please, you got to clear away all this rubbish in the house, I tell you, buyers cannot stand a place that's got so many old memories. And these hideous statues, Jin Pai Kuan,
throw away down.
What?
I said put that down! What? Do you know how hard it is to find these nowadays?
I'm just trying to help, okay? Tell me, the one from where?
Malacca, 1974. Honeymoon, huh?
This one?
Penang, 1978.
Ayo! got anything from this century or not, huh?
Everything here is from 20 years ago, you know.
Huh? And this one best, huh? Scotch tape some more. Hey, ma, broken just throw away lah, huh?
You broke that one!
Me? Forgot.
Huh? Why so late?
Oh, launching new project today, yes.
Huh, another one.
Hey, no, no, ma. This one is special.
Special?
Oh, special. I tell you, it's right by the harbour and it's got an amazing view of the sea. It's 36 stories high. And you know, ma, it's... Ma, you're not listening.
I am listening, listening. Yeah.
I mean, would you like an amazing view of the sea? Hey, why not?
Makes me want to. I vomit.
Huh?
Seasick.
Like what?
Like.
Crazy.
I like looking out my window at my little tree. Okay?
Tree. Bloody termites.
What?
The tree. Yeah.
Oi, choy. Hey, don't curse my tree. There are no termites. Perfectly healthy.
The tree, you should just cut down.
Yeah, huh? Cut down, throw away. Hey, you don't touch my tree. Don't touch my statues. Don't touch my things.
But ma, everything is so... Ayyo. And best, you won't even peel those stickers off the wall, you know.
You put them there.
Me?
Yeah. Who else, when you were 6, and you really liked Ultraman and Spider-Man, but what? Your favourite was Superman. You used to wear red panties outside of your pants. And then you tie my blanket around your shoulders like a kid. You go jump to sofa, rescuing don't know who. Think about it then, who knows what you were thinking? Remember or not?
No.
Yeah, where got don't remember? Then you go to my jade cupboard, take out my jade, and pretend it's that. Guppy, grippy, gopi, that rock, that green one, what do you call it? Hey, asking you a question, you deaf or what?
Kryptonite lah.
See? You also remember.
No, I do remember. Anyway, I never had any red underwear. What? All my briefs were white, lor.
Yeah, huh? Hey, maybe it was my panties. Okay lah. I'm a senile already, Bit like this house.
Ayo, ma. I don't understand how you can live in this dump, you know. If I were you, right, I'd run far, far away. Maybe migrate to another country, One that's not so hot. Maybe with snow. England? Hey, ma, I want to go see snow, lah.
See for what? I opened my freezer, I can see already.
It's not like that, okay. See, imagine. Snowflakes drifting down from the sky, then melting when they touch your skin.
Woohoo! Shook your head, You want, you go, lah.
But you know I cannot write.
Why?
Because
who asked you? Act smart lah, gay kiang lah, invest in property until everything also crash. Hey, don't give me that kind of face. How old are you already?
Yeah, ma, just trying to help, ma. This house, you know.
It's not your house.
Yeah, I know lah, but
it's not mine either. It belongs to him.
15 years ready, leh, ma.
So? That's right. Please deal.
Alright. But...
What?
15 years.
So?
It's a bit short, isn't it?
Short?
I mean, it's only 15 years. The whole cycle of life and death. The body hasn't got a chance to fully decompose and return back to the earth from where it sprung from. They've suffered so much already. Shouldn't they have the right to rest in peace for a little longer than 15 years?
Look, Ivan, you've been in this ministry for how long?
2 years.
2 years. You are not unaware, surely, of the circumstances of our country?
No, Director.
Then you tell me, in this country, what is more precious? Sand or gold?
Sand.
And who is more important, living or dead?
Living.
It is only natural that we should optimize our most precious resource. I mean, why should the living have to suffer for the dead? Who pays taxes, living or dead?
Living.
Anyway, there's not much opposition. Most of these cases are straightforward, cremation, claimed by the family, case closed, except for these few. And remember, here at the ministry, we always re...
What?
We always re...
Cycle.
Re...
Use.
Re...
Allocate.
The triple re strategy. That's all there is to it. But if you think it's such a big deal then, why don't you go and find out what the situation is on the grassroots level? No point arguing from an ivory tower.
All right.
You should make a site visit.
Huh? A site visit?
To the cemetery. Interview the relevant stakeholders. Find out what the situation on the ground is. Or in the ground, for that matter.
But...
you're the one that's so concerned about this issue. Any other questions?
No.
Just submit your site report by next Monday.
Boone, just go back and talk to the client. Just okay. Ask him for an evaluation or something and just ask. And
but I don't just like how it works, you know? It's just very weird. So, is there any other way to
do it?
Hey! Just do something else.
Cheng,
cheng, cheng! Wait,
the keys to paradise.
Hey, don't talk rubbish.
No, really. These are the keys to my new condominium, Sunset Bay, unit 2601.
Oh, hey! Isn't that the one with the amazing sea view?
Yeah, don't play. This is not your basic luxury condo. This is a one-of-a-kind, ultra-exclusive, high-end luxury sky villa. It's even got individual yacht berths and a 24-hour concierge service, okay?
Oh, really?
Oi, wait until I invite you for housewarming can, Lord.
So lucky, my place is only ready in Q4 next year. I say my in-laws will even vomit blood.
Well... so where will you be staying after that?
Scott's Place, very short walk down only shopping center.
Nice.
Hey, didn't you buy that unit in River Valley a while back?
No, don't talk about it really lah. Oh, I lost so much money on that one, you know. Oh, never even get to collect my keys.
No, I tell you, it's all about the timing. So where are you staying now?
None of your business, lah.
Don't tell me you're still staying with your mother.
Yay! He's still staying with his mother! Hey, Boon, huh? Don't mind, okay? I give you some advice, okay? No money to buy condominium, never mind, huh? Hey. Still no girlfriend, right?
It's okay.
You wait until you're 35 when the government give up on you, then you buy your HDB flat lah.
Hey, you, shut up lah. People filial son, okay? Not everyone is like you, staying in a posh condominium or your father stays in an old folks home. Boon, come over.
What?
So where are you staying now?
Same old lor, Zion mentioned lah.
Zion Mansion. Hey, wasn't that built in the Qing Dynasty or something? You mean it hasn't gone en bloc yet?
Huh?
on block? Residue. That's what all this place is. Mud you can clean up. Cobwebs you can sweep away. Stains, use bleach lah. But how to erase the history of your own life? When even the Superman stickers refuse to come off, but still cling desperately to the wall. White and scrappy. And when the scuff marks on the parquet look like train tracks, and black grime strangles the bathroom taps like alien tentacles out of a B-grade movie, that is what I call residue. And it's all his fault. Half the time, she's down on her knees trying to scrub the stain of him off the floor. But what's the point, huh? He might as well still be here. So what? If I got a bulletproof body and X-ray vision, huh? What's the point if he's gonna be burying those walls like kryptonite? Making me feel like some kunyan. Like some damsel in distress. Waiting for someone to come and save me. Who's gonna come and save me, huh? Sometimes, you just have to do the rescuing yourself. What the? Oh shit! Oh shit! Oh shit! 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 Shit. Gosh, I'm such an idiot! Shit! Excuse me, Mr. Chan? Mr. Chanakao, my name's Ivan Chong. I'm from the Land Ministry. I'm here to, in line with the Triple R policy, the Land Ministry has decided to limit the burial period of all graves to 15 years. With limited land available, it is necessary to extend the lifespan of all cemeteries to cater for future burials. I am pleased to inform you that your grave will be part of phase one of this exhumation exercise, which will begin in a month's time. Next of kin will be informed via newspaper notices or the ministry's website. Next of kin may request for a reburial under new space-saving allocation scheme or a cremation in the columbarium.
Now, if you don't mind, Mr. Chan, I'll be back in a month's time when you're due for exhumation.
No!
What was that?
No!
Oh shit! Oh shit, 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 shit!
I said no!
Gosh, I knew I shouldn't have that Red Bull before coming here.
No, 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 no!
Talk to the stakeholders, she said. Sentiment in the ground, indeed!
I said no, you hear me?
No.
No?
I don't hear you. Yes. Sorry. Did you say something?
I said... no!
I'm sorry to disturb you, sir, but this cemetery is only 318 hectares in size and we will be used up by the end of this year without the new burying policy.
Huh?
What?
My name.
Your name?
Name, not Chan.
Huh? But it says here in my papers, Mr. Chan Ah Kow, deceased 1992.
No, not Chan Ah Kow.
Are you sure? I mean, I have your name right here. The details.
No!
Okay. Maybe it's a clerical error or something. It's quite hard to find good support staff nowadays. So, if you don't mind, just give me your correct name.
No.
Huh?
No.
Don't you want to set the record straight?
Can't remember.
Can't remember what?
Name, not Chan, but can't remember.
Okay, what about your family?
Huh?
Are you married, single, divorced, widowed? Do you have any children? Sons, daughters, brothers, sisters, nieces, nephews?
Don't remember!
I don't suppose you remember where you live?
No! No, wait!
What?
Sound!
Huh? What sound?
That sound! Boom, boom, boom! Boom, boom, boom!
Oh, that sound. They're building castles.
Huh?
That sound. The sound of construction. The sound of progress.
Am I in heaven or am I in hell?
I'm sorry to inform you, but this is neither. This is Bukit Brown Cemetery, Bukit Brown Lot 1.
How long have I been here?
15 years.
15 years?
Yes, and this brings me back to my original point. Now, as I said, with limited land available, this necessitates the exhumation program. Next of kin may request for a reburial, or else...
Or else what?
Or else, unclaimed graves will be exhumed and the remains cremated. After 3 years, scattered into the sea.
No!
What?
Don't touch me!
Believe me, I don't want to!
No fire! No burning!
I am not trying to!
You are trying? Don't kill me! Huh? Die one time already! No more!
No, I'm not trying to kill you! No, no, no!
Why can't you just leave me alone?
I wish I could, Mr. Chan.
Go away! Don't disturb me!
I'm trying to help! If you give me your correct name, I can do the paperwork for you!
No name, no name! I got no name! Just go! Go away!
Okay, I'm going. I'm only trying to help.
Go! Boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom.
Crazy!
But it's the perfect solution, Ma! You see, you sell it on the open market, right?
than peanuts. Huh? Nobody's going to put their money to a place like this. But when you get everybody to sell together, huh, that's when the magic happens. Hey, I tell you, this place like got potential to become really classy.
Aya, classy your head lah.
Oh, you know, down the road, right, Tong Gardens was sold last month for 45 million, okay? 45 million! I bet this place will not go for a cent less. Oh, I bet even most uncles right, never even dream of earning so much money in their lifetime.
Nonsense! Nobody will want to sell.
Yeah, ma, not everyone is as irrational as you, okay?
Ah, you see lah, huh? You see, how many people will want to sign?
Once you see the numbers right, they will be queuing up to sign. You will be crazy not to know.
Ah, you say already what, right? I'm a crazy woman.
Look, Mama. I know you're really attached to this flat, huh? But, it's old and rotting. It's falling to pieces. I mean, the wiring, shit like that, huh? The leakage problems keep getting worse. Oh, and best, the bloody termites are still around. Hey, Ma, for the amount of money we can get right, we can buy a really nice place, you know. Oh, and I mean really nice. Hey, you want to stay at a semi-detached house, right? Also can, you know. Or even a bungalow, if you don't mind moving up north.
Yeah, but I mind. I mind a lot.
Okay.
Don't want to leave.
Fine, fine. Since you like this place so much, we'll get a new condominium around here. Hmm? One with a fantastic view of trees. Huh? Hundreds of them if you like.
I don't like. Don't want hundreds. Only want one. My one.
Hey, Ma.
Ayah, don't mommy. You know how I feel about this place.
Well, I'm not sure everyone feels the same way as you do.
Tan Tiong Boon! Don't you dare talk about selling my place in front of me again. You understand me? I'm warning you, or else.
Or else what?
Or else I will have no son like you!
Ma!
Wow!
What?
You silly fellow! You never told me you had so much money. You sure can afford this?
No need to worry about that. Not enough. Just borrow, lor.
Borrow, so one day have to pay back, right? Sure not. Work, lor. You work, lor. I'm not gonna work. I'm gonna enjoy life. I'm going to sit down in my kitchen, drink my bird's nest, and look out of this window. Well, you make money for me. Can or not?
Can! For you, anything also can.
Real or blood?
Since when did I bluff you? It's okay, you know. If you don't want to live here, you don't have to. It's an investment. I can still sell and make money.
So, you must be crazy. Everything also, money, money, money. Of course I like it. Why shouldn't I like it? I like everything. Even the floor. I like the floor. I've never seen a floor so white before. I've never smelled a floor so white before. My whole life, I've lived inside borrowed walls, bathed in borrowed bathrooms, and slept on borrowed floors. But now, everything, the floor, the walls, the kitchen tiles, the window grill, the doorknobs, even the doorknobs are beautiful.
So, Zabo, doorknobs are so beautiful. You think this is good? You just wait. Next time, when I make enough money, I'll buy you a big bungalow. Inside, got spiral staircase and marble floor. Whoa. Outside, a big garden full of rambutan trees and your very own swimming pool. I tell you, you haven't seen anything yet.
Don't need anything else. This is good enough.
Your dreams are too big for me.
And yours are just too small. Come, I've got a surprise for you.
What? In the kitchen?
No.
Backyard! What do you have in the backyard?
Oh God! Corpses are the same as ghosts. Corpses rot. Ghosts haunt. The only thing connecting them is the raincoat smell of death. Ghosts have long memories. They are part of the past. They are insubstantial, drifting in and out of walls, leaving no trace when they pass. Except for this feeling of coldness, of dampness. Corpses, on the other hand, are muddy, mucky, stinking of rotten fruit and decomposing flesh. When you are a corpse, you are nothing but a cluster of organic matter whose only purpose is to decay. That's the only progress possible. As you seep back into the earth, cell by cell. But as the soil soaks up your stories, your memory slowly being leached away. Yet, in doing so, you leave your own corpse-shaped imprint onto the earth. In your decay lies your immortality.
Dear sir!
Dear madam.
Dear sir slash madam.
We refer to your letter dated 2nd of January, 2007.
We refer to your letter dated 10th January, 2007.
We refer to a telephone call on the 23rd of January at 3 p.m. and the one on 1st February at 5 p.m, 3rd February, 5th February, 6th February and 7th February.
After much deliberation,
after careful consideration,
we regret to inform you that
in view of your circumstances,
in this situation,
given the current considerations,
we are unable to accommodate your request.
We regret to inform you that we are unable to make an exception for your case.
We think it's a bunch of lousy bullshit and we really have much better ways of spending our time than doing useless crap like this! Do you really think the taxpayers' money should be squandered away on a piece of useless shit like you?
Thank you for your feedback.
Thank you for your feedback.
Thank you for your feedback.
Yours sincerely, Director Land.
Deputy Director Land.
Assistant Director, Len. Why do we even bother with this?
I'm serving out my bond. You are doing this voluntarily. You should talk.
Complain. Hey, they think we got nothing better to do, is it?
We are civil servants. We have to try. Or at least show that we are trying.
Oh, hey, you should see this one. Got on blocks here already, still not happy. People throw money at her, still want to complain. Going on and on about some stupid fig tree.
Fig tree?
That's right, fig tree. Husband planted it for her 30 years ago. Sentimental value, blah blah blah. Hey, I also can.
How come you're dealing with this?
Aya, land ma. Whether it's to build expensive condo on, bury dead people in, or even plant some bloody fig tree, it's still the same land. Well, sort of. Oh, by the way, how did your site visit to the cemetery go?
Not so good.
Why? Not so bad, what?
Just pretend it's a more ulu part of the Botanic Gardens. Walk around, get some fresh air, greenery. Better than being stuck in this pathetic office, what?
Well, it was a bit awkward.
Awkward? A site visit?
Can I tell you a secret? Promise me you won't scream.
Wow, so drama, Anna.
Well, the thing is, I've never told this to anyone before, but I can speak to a. I can speak to corpses.
What the hell is? You mean
not so loud? It's not that scary.
You mean like in Sixth Sense, you see dead people?
Yes, I see them. But then again, so do you.
Hey, choy!
Corpses, they're not like ghosts. Corpses are muddy, mucky, but they're certainly not invisible. I can hear them. Or at least hear their stories.
How do you know these things? Wait, I don't know.
It was my mother's funeral. I was 8.
So did the cops talk to you?
Unfortunately, yes.
Eee! So, what do you do?
What else could I do? I talk back.
So, what do you talk to your cops about?
My cops? Hey, wait. He's certainly not my cops. I've got nothing to do with him.
Right, you're just the officer in charge.
That's right. Anyway, we're about policies, not people. Nothing personal.
Right, the faceless bureaucrat. Oh, which reminds me, director was looking for you just now. Now that's a scary sight.
Just want to leave something behind.
What
do you mean there's a problem?
Not so much of a problem. More like a minor hitch.
Then unhitch it.
Well, the thing is, misidentification. The name of the grave stated in the file is incorrect.
Then correct it.
Well, it's not so straightforward. The body does not want to be exhumed, cremated, or whatsoever.
But that we're not asking, Ivan. This is not a consultation process. This is an implementation process.
Right.
So why the hell are you all gathering feedback like a primary school student on assignment? I don't want feedback. I need action. And I need that site report.
Well, the thing is, I really can't go back there. I really can't.
You can't. Then what do we pay you for? To sit in your air-conditioned cubicle and shake leg, is it?
No, I mean, couldn't you send someone else?
Oh, I see. Just because somebody's a scholar, certain assignments become too distasteful, is it?
No, it's not that. It's just that you don't understand.
I don't want to understand. I don't need to understand. I just want the site report on my table by this Monday. Is that so unreasonable?
Yes. I mean, Monday's fine.
How do you expect me to show my face to other people? You have shamed me.
Ma, I don't see what's the big deal, okay?
It's bad enough that you nag me day in, day out. Why must you go and disturb our neighbors until like that?
I never disturb our neighbors. I'm just trying to help, okay?
Oh, you still dare say you help?
Yeah, I am trying to help, but come on, it's for our own good, but. Anyway, they have raised the price again. Ma, it's a damn good deal.
How did I manage to raise a son like you, huh? All you care about is money, money, money! You don't care about this place at all!
This place? What's so great about this place, huh? You give me one good reason why I should care about this place.
Taste this!
Taste what?
Go on, taste it!
What?
The floor, lah! Like this!
Ew!
Go on, taste it!
Okay, I'll do it. But I think you're crazy.
Can you taste it?
Taste what?
It's salty.
Don't talk, Rory.
It is, isn't it? That's my sweat you taste of. My blood, after all these years, I really seep into the floors of this house. Even the floors smell of them. The taste of them. My sweat, my blood, my tears, my memories, my life.
Siao la, ma! This is exactly what I mean, you know, huh? Salty floors. Oh. I tell you what, it's bad enough that I'm squeezed into that pathetic excuse of a room, okay? Now you want to come and talk to me about salty floors? Ma, I just want a normal floor, okay? Normal floor, clean and shiny. No sweat, no blood, no tears. No, nothing of that, okay?
If you've had enough, you go lah.
Think I don't dare to? Hey, I only stay here because of you, huh?
You go, huh? You think I can't take care of myself?
Yeah. I think you do. I think you will go crazy if I'm not here.
That's not true. I don't need you.
Oh, I tell you, it's not for me, right? You die here, nobody will show no
hope. Hey, I got friends, okay?
Friends? Huh? What friends, huh? The gossip queen next door? Hey. If the price is high enough, she will sell her children, okay? Who else? Huh? Oh, Mrs. Lim?
That one got stroke, cannot recognize you already. Everybody else died already,
How dare you speak like that, huh? You think you're so smart? You go and find your own place to stay.
Oh, you want me to go? I'll call you!
Yeah, I want you to go! Leave! Get out of my house!
Okay, fine! I go!
Kid!
Aiya! Only for 1 week!
That's what you said the last time. Then in the end?
That time really? Bo pian what?
Why must you keep going to Bangkok?
Don't you understand? Business is like that!
And you're going with? I'll take those people.
Hey, what you want me to bring back from Bangkok? I heard you like the dried mango side. Why don't I bring back some for you and the boy?
Everything is so dull one.
Ayo! Don't be like that! I promise, when I come back from this trip, I'll bring you and our boy for a holiday. Maybe we can go to the mountains. There, you can see snow, and our boy can learn how to ski, or even build a snowman.
Don't anyhow waste money. I don't want to go anywhere.
Why? You scared I won't come back, is it?
I wish.
I'll always come back, as long as you're here. I've got a good feeling about this trip, you know. If things work out according to plan, I promise you, you are going to live like a queen. This hand don't need to do housework anymore. Just point, point, point like that. And everything will get done.
Queen your head. You think so easy,
Trust me, lah.
You silly fellow.
Hello? Hello, Mr. Chan? Mr. Chan Akao? Or whatever your name is. It's me again, Ivan, from the Land Ministry. Hello? Hello?
Said already, right? Go away.
Yeah, I know, but I think I can help about the cremation.
No, don't want.
I know, but the thing is, if you give me your family's name, maybe they can come and claim you. There are extreme circumstances, but not when you're an unidentified grave. So please, just give me a name, someone I can work with.
No, go away.
You sure you can't remember your family? Your wife?
No family, nothing.
What about your address? Your home?
Don't have, I got no home, nothing.
There's got to be something.
Nothing! I got nothing!
You're not even trying, Mr. Chan. Why am I even talking to you? You're just
a corpse for Christ's sake. You represent nothing but take up unnecessary space in the ground. And you stink of rotten fruit and decomposing flesh. Why the hell do I even bother arguing with you?
You started it, what?
Hey! I should be back in my ivory tower right now, on the 15th floor, overlooking the business district, my perfectly climate-controlled office, sitting on my ergonomic chair, sipping my mocha frappuccino, making sweeping policies that affect the entire nation. Not out here, under the sun. I mean, it's bloody hot out here. I'm like squatting like some frog, sweating like some pig. If I wanted to work under these conditions, I've been a construction worker or something. Not a bloody bureaucrat. I can't even get a bloody coke out here.
Hot?
Yes, hot.
Like what?
I say already. Like the sun lah.
Ah, sun. Like what?
Like it'll burn the skin off my back. That kind of sun. That kind of hot.
Burning?
Yes, burning. Like, it'll burn my skin raw. Except for this bloody long sleeve shirt. It's now soaked in sweat and clinging onto my back.
Sweat?
Damp. That burning. My face. I can feel the sweat seeping through the pores and rising to the surface of my skin. And my hair. Has that too? That burning? If you put your hand on it, you can feel that black, burning heat. I haven't been this hot since I was in primary school. I forced to stand outside the basketball court for punishment.
I remember hot.
You do?
Had enough of her, and enough of leaving that sheeple, okay?
Just go back and talk to her. It doesn't make sense.
Look. She was the one who kicked me out, okay? She doesn't want me? Fine. Let her go and terrorize somebody else for a change. I don't want to be bossed around by her anymore. And I don't want to live in that sheeple anymore.
Hey, don't talk like that.
You know, honestly, I really hate being a property agent, you know? Every day, I wake up and go and see those beautiful new condominiums, huh? Smelling of fresh paint and varnish. And then, at night, when I go back, to go back to that pigsty, huh? The shithole, where even the floor smells of armpits! Oh my god!
Armpits?
For sweat la! Hey,
I ask you, why? Is the grass always so damn green on the other side, tell me?
Boon, because those people got gardener to pull out the weeds. Got maid to water the plants. Got dog to fertilize the garden. Even got exterminator to kill the caterpillars. They have to pay a bomb, okay? So the bloody grass better be greener on the other side. Hey, I really wish I could help you, but you know my mother-in-law is so one kind.
Never mind lah. I'll figure something out, okay?
Actually, how about that place? Very cheap.
Where?
Can rent by the hour. I know. Hotel 81?
Ayyo! You want me to go stay at the kind of place?
Or those backpacking hotels in Katong or Ubin or
Thank you very much, huh? But hey, I'm not on a holiday, okay? Every day I still have to get up and go to work, so.
I've got it!
Come on!
The perfect solution! But you mustn't tell anyone!
What are you talking about?
Tang!
What's this?
The keys to paradise.
Huh?
Paradise Garden show flat lah. What do you think I was talking about? A place beyond imagination. Come home to paradise. We only start marketing next week, but the showroom's already done.
you sure about this?
Yes, just promise me you won't get caught.
Pa, how are you doing?
None of your business.
Ayo, what happened to the floor, Pa?
Not your problem, boy. Get in the house.
Ayo, but why like that?
Did you hear what I say?
Ayo, it's very bad. Pa's going to be very angry there.
No, she won't.
Oh, you know, Pa,
last time I take the chalk, right, then I draw the hopscotch on the floor, right, your Ma is so very angry at me, leh. You know, she right,
better not tell her. Or else.
You want me to lie to Ma, is it?
No. I'm just telling you to shut up!
But I shut up so you can see why. See, Pa?
Get in the house!
But it's not my fault, I never do anything!
Don't argue with me! Get in the house! You asking for it, is it?
But it's not me, it's you, Pa! You know you're the one that...
The one that what?
I don't know how I know, Pa! You should
you
know!
You still not some more!
It's not my fault!
You wait! Just wait!
Pa, this is so unfair! How can you be like that, Pa?
Go in!
Okay. Hey, Pa! Pa!
You are so cocky! I'm done with you!
Pa! Pa, don't want! Let me go! Let me go, Pa!
I'm gonna teach you a lesson! You're never gonna forget!
Pa! Pa, I don't want! I don't want! Let me go! Let me
don't
go.
Get what you want!
I hate you, Pa! I hate you! I hate you! Let me go! I don't want! I don't want! I don't want, Pa!